In this video, we're going to learn how to add questions to a quiz. So I'm logged into Invanto and I'm going to go into Access for CoTrack. I'm going to choose the course that I want to add the quiz to and click the Edit button. Under the tabs on the second line, I'm going to choose Curriculum and I'm going to choose my first lesson and I'm going to choose to edit that first lesson. And I'm going to go to the quiz section. And as you can see, I've got a quiz added, but there aren't any questions. There's two ways to add questions to this quiz. The first way is to click Add Question. Here you can choose the question type. You can choose an objective, which just has one answer, a multiple choice, which can have more than one answer, a paragraph, which is one that is going to have to be submitted for assessment. The student won't be able to get the results right away. They won't get the results until the instructor grades it and checks it on their own and then returns the results to the student. And file is the same way. It has to go through the assessment process with the instructor. The results won't be returned until the instructor has reviewed the answer. Let's go ahead and choose a multiple choice question for ours. I can also choose a category. And since we're in the sales letters section of our course, I'm going to go to sales letters. So I'm going to enter the information. So I've entered the information about our question that we want to add to our quiz. The question is, what should you include in the headline of your sales letter? I've set this as a multiple choice question. It's in the category of sales letters. One potential answer is attention-grabbing words that entice the potential customer to find out more about your product. This is checkmarked because it is a correct answer. The next potential answer is your company's name, address, phone, and fax number for potential customers to contact you. It is unchecked because this is an incorrect answer. And I've got information why it's incorrect. This can be added at the bottom of your sales letter page. The next answer is your pricing for the products that you are presenting in your sales letter. It is unchecked because it's incorrect. And it's incorrect because pricing should be towards the bottom of the sales letters. And it goes on to say you want to get them excited about your product before you give them the price. The next potential answer is a subheading for reinforcement of the main headline. This is checkmarked because it's a correct answer. It explains that using more attention-grabbing words in the subheading will further excite your potential customers to find out more about your product. In this particular case, we've got two correct answers. I'm going to click Save and save my question. So now I have a question that I've added to my quiz. That's one way that you can add a question. The second way to add a question is to add it straight from the question bank. You have the ability to create a bunch of questions, add them to the question bank, and then pull them into your quizzes. So if you'll take a look on this left-hand side, you've got a couple of buttons right here. This first button is to just add a question from scratch. The second button is to add a question from the question bank. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. I've got all of my questions from the question bank listed right here. I could actually search if I knew the title of the question or even search by the question type, the categories. But I know my question is the very first one here, so I'm going to click on it. And then I'm going to click the single arrow button, and it's going to move it over into my selected questions. And then I'm going to click Save. Now I want you to notice these buttons. If I wanted to move all of them over, I could click the double arrow that points to the right. If I wanted to get all of these out of the quiz, I could pick the double arrow going to the left. And for single questions, I pick the single arrow. I pulled my question over. I'm going to click Save. Now my question's been added, so I go back into the quiz area. And you can see now that I have pulled that second question in. The question is, when creating a sales letter, what is a call to action? I have three possible answers, and because this is a different type of question, I'm going to go into edit so you can see, this is an objective question, so there's only going to be one correct answer. So I'll click Save, and now I've got two questions added to my quiz in two different ways. Just to review, you can add a question using this button right here, or you could add a question from the quiz bank using this button right here.